Have you been hearing about FHIR and people around the world using it for interoperability, but you just don't know where to start? Or maybe you know a little about FHIR, but when you tried to develop your own application and wanted to integrate with an EHR, you just felt stuck? I'm Dr. Sidharth Ramesh, and the Build 5 Applications in 10 Weeks Bootcamp is meant specifically for developers who want a practical understanding of FHIR from the ground up. Here's what to expect after you sign up. You will receive a confirmation email securing your spot in the bootcamp, and you will get an invitation to our FHIR Bootcamp Slack channel where you can introduce yourself and you can get to know our instructors and other participants across the world. 1 week before the start of the bootcamp, you will receive access to the e-learning platform. Here's how the bootcamp will work. Every 2 weeks, we will try to build one real-world application from scratch. The e-learning platform will contain all the recorded videos that you need to understand the concepts in depth for you to build these applications. There are quizzes that you can test yourself with to get a deeper understanding of these concepts as well. There will be one live class per week. In the first week, we will have a kickoff class where we go over the specifics of what you are expected to build. We will then have a follow-up question and answer session where you can ask any questions that you might have. The following days are for you to build your application, and you can always refer the coding tutorials that are available on the e-learning platform. But I usually recommend that you try to build it yourself and get stuck and then come to us with support and questions instead of looking at just the coding tutorials and following it as it is. Now for support, you can reach out to us on the Slack channel for immediate help. You can ask questions directly on the e-learning platform. You can schedule one-to-one sessions with me or your designated coding instructor. We'll all be there to help you, you know, debug your code and find out exactly how you can finish your assignment. And on the second week, we'll have another live session where we will have a demo day. So the demo day is for all the participants to show the application that you have built. So this is a safe space and you can show your application even if it's incomplete. And this is for you to just learn what others have built and look at the creativity from their side, learn new concepts from others as well as the instructors and me. The end of the second week, you're expected to submit your coding assignment and it will be reviewed by one of our instructors, and you will pass if you meet all the requirements for that particular application. And if you've completed the application, congratulations, you are now ready for the next module, for which we will again start off with the kickoff class and then have a demo day, and we'll rinse and repeat this for all of the 5 modules. So here's a quick breakdown of all the applications that you'll build. In module 1, we'll be building a patient management application where we will start with the basics of FHIR and how you can interact with FHIR REST APIs. Your app will be able to create, edit, and delete patients on a FHIR server. In module 2, with the smart patient app on Epic, we will learn the basics of building a smart on FHIR application, which patients can use to view their own EHR data in your app. In module 3, with the smart practitioner app on Cerner, we will learn about the smart EHR launch, which doctors and practitioners can use to open up your app within their EHR workflow and view existing EHR data as well as write data back to the EHR. In module 4, we will work with the smart backend application on Epic, where we will learn about JWT authentication, FHIR bulk APIs, and how your app can run in the background without ever needing user interaction. And finally, in module 5, which is optional, we will work on the FHIR facade on Postgres, where we learn in depth how EHRs like Epic or Cerner built their FHIR APIs to begin with. We will look at different techniques to achieve a FHIR compliant API, and we will build a FHIR server from scratch ourselves using popular open source frameworks. So you may now be thinking, is this FHIR Bootcamp really for me? To answer that question, let me tell you who this FHIR Bootcamp is not for. If you don't know how to code at all, and you have no idea how to build a working application, then this bootcamp is not for you. We expect you to build a real working application at the end of each module. So if you have no prior coding experience, then this may not be the course for you. You will need to build one application every 2 weeks. So you will need to dedicate some time. And if you don't have this time and you have a hectic schedule, then this course may not be for you. And an approximate amount of hours would probably be 10 hours per week that you may want to dedicate to this, because you will need to build that one application per module in 2 weeks. If you're looking for HL7's official FHIR proficiency exam, or if you want preparation for this exam, then this bootcamp may not be for you. We offer practical training on building these real world applications, and we don't really do exam prep here. So if you are just interested in the official proficiency certification and the exam, then this may not be for you. If you want to learn about HL7 V2, V3, CCDA, or anything that is not HL7 FHIR, then this course may not be for you, because we exclusively focus on HL7 FHIR and FHIR APIs. And finally, if you want to have a practical experience with HL7 paradigms that are not FHIR REST, so these include things like India's ABDM or Saudi Arabia's NAFIS or IHC's, XDS over FHIR, these are all local variants of the FHIR, paradigm, and they have different ways of working. And we go in depth on the FHIR REST APIs with a focus on the US core profiles so that you can work with EHRs like Epic, Cerner, and so on. So if you're looking for these other FHIR paradigms, especially for these other countries, then this bootcamp may not be for you. If you have any more questions, feel free to check out the frequently asked questions section down below. There is another video explaining a lot more questions in depth. And you can also just reach out to us, fill out the contact us form, and we'll get back to you. If you think this FHIR bootcamp is for you and you will get value out of it, then sign up today.